Hey everyone, how's it going? Thanks so much for tuning in. Today we had a nice weather here in Ontario, so I would just go ahead and make a video of something that I've never done before. So in today's video, I'm going to be changing the engine air filter on my 2012 Ford Focus with only 114,000 kilometers. And I've owned this thing since November 2015, 4 years ago, and it's still running good. So let's get into it. Alright, so in today's video, we're going to be installing the Ford Motorcraft air filter. They are really good, high-quality air filters built by the Ford Motor Company. And also, I'd like to thank one of my friends at Kirkland Lake, home of the upfront guys at Pinewood Park Motors, for providing me with the air filter so I can install it in my car. So let's do that now. Alright, first thing we're going to do is go under the hood, open the door first, and then just open the hood latch. So here are a couple of tools that you're going to need. You're going to need a smaller ratchet and longer extension, and as well as the 5/16 socket. Fits right on the long extension and the smaller ratchet too. And you're also going to need a new engine air filter. Just make sure you have the right part number here. It says FA1908. So that's what we want. So let's get started. Now on the air filter cover, you're going to have to locate all four screws that hold in this air filter cover into place. You can see right here, there's four of them. You can see right here, there's one screw, one right here, one down there, and there's one right here, and one right there. So you're going to undo those four screws in order to get this air filter cover out. Alright, so first thing we're going to do is unscrew these four screws. So you can do this job by yourself without spending any money. To take it to a dealer. And just do that. Those screws just come off really easy. Don't just unscrew it all the way. Just enough so they let go of the bottom of the holes there. And that's about it. Oops, gotta get to that bottom there. Okay, I'm just gonna have to remove this cover for the battery here. There we go. I'll just place it here. So that way I'll have enough room for the last screw in the back. And it's really awesome. It's not gonna cost you a penny taking it to a dealer. Just do this by yourself and just save yourself some money without spending a penny. And that's how it works. You just loosen this last bolt right here. Just loosen this up like that. Just grab your finger and then just loosen up this screw. And there you go. And then the air filter cover should slide right off. Yeah, it's not going to come off easy. So I'm going to show you a trick. Now the only tool that I'm going to use is this flat blade screwdriver. This small tool here, which will help get this thing off really easy. Just slide it right in there, over here. And it should help pry it off. Okay, hang on. Alright, so I just got this part open here. Sometimes you just have to play around with it in order to get this thing out. I'll just have to use this thing here to help pry this thing out. There we go. That wasn't so bad. All right, there's the old air filter, so I'm just going to take the old one out, and I'm going to show you what it looks like here. We'll see what it looks like after 8 years and 114,000 kilometers. This whole thing should slide right out, just like that. And this is it. 8 years in 2012 and 114,000 kilometers on this original air filter. So I'm just going to clean this box out, and then we'll just get the new one in, and we should have no problems. All right, so we just cleaned out all that grass and debris that got caught on this air filter housing. So we're just going to go ahead and grab our brand new air filter, and then the new one will go in without leaving any gaps. So we'll try this one here. So this new air filter came in a plastic wrap right here. This is actually my first time changing the air filter on my car, and I've never done anything like this. I've never done any maintenance on the car myself since I bought it. I never changed the air filter on my car before. Like I said, it's actually my first time, and I've never done anything like this before. I'll place it over here. So there's the new air filter and the old one over here. So always compare your parts and make sure that they're the same here. In this case, ours was. So we'll just go ahead and put the new air filter in. I'll just set the old one down here. So before installing the new air filter, just pay attention to this tab here. It has to go down in that slot there. And then just slide that. This thing goes right in there. So make sure you align the tab that goes right in the slot as you're sliding the new thing right in there. My only trick is how to get this thing in there. I just had to take off this fuse box so I can have more room in here, so I can align the groove or the slot there. So make sure you get it in there good. Alright, so I got the air filter on. My only trick is I had to push it in order to get that tab to go right in that slot there to make a perfect fit. So that's about it. Alright, so we're just going to get everything all put back together, and we'll be done. Alright, so first we're going to put the cover back on. Just make sure you line up the holes over here. Okay. Now we'll just screw it on. It's really nice. tight enough now. Yeah, I guess it should be fairly on there. All right, next we're gonna put this fuse box back on. Pushes back in there, and then we'll put the cover back on for the battery. Make sure you line it up. And there you have it. All right, so I just tightened up all four screws. This one here, one down there, one right there, and one right there. So the screw was just spinning, so I didn't get it to tighten down all the way. So I guess it should be okay. It's not gonna come loose while driving. And so I just had to double check to make sure I have the tab inside this slot. And it's a really nice, perfect fit on that. So now that's basically it. All right, next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and start the engine. See if we got good airflow. All right, moment of truth, here we go. Let's go check this out. Yep. She fits really good. Yeah, she's running good. So I'm not gonna let it run for too long. Yep, she's running good so far, and I don't see no check engine light come on. And that's basically it. So I'm going to go ahead and shut it off. There you go. Now, one last thing to remember is to carefully take the air filter out of the box without ripping the box, therefore making it easier to return to the store if any case it doesn't fit. And that's basically it. In this case, my filter does have a perfect fit, so my trick is, like I said, my only trick to get it in there, you just have to align that tab to get into that slot there. And there you have it. All right, so we're going to go ahead and close the hood since I'm done with my maintenance. All right. Well, everyone, I hope you enjoy my video of me changing my engine air filter on my 2012 Ford Focus SE with only 114,000 kilometers. And also, I hope this video taught you how to change your own engine air filter on your Ford Focus model years 2012 or 2014 and up. If this video is helpful, and if it was, remember to give it a thumbs up. And also, if you're not subscribed yet, consider subscribing. Up on the screen, I have a couple of videos related to this, such as how to change an engine air filter on a brand new 2020 Ford Escape. If you want to check that out, you just go ahead and go on my channel and then just look for how to change an engine air filter on a 2020 Ford Escape. And also, don't forget to subscribe to my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, or just follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, where I should say. And also, remember, as always, like, subscribe, favorite. Be sure to stay tuned next time. There's always a lot more where it came from. Take care.